In a few clicks, users could enable the collection and visualization of the most common data provided by Juniper's telemetry solutions. Hello, my name is David Rao. I'm a technical marketing engineer at Juniper Network. Today, I'm thrilled to present you a sidetime project I recently developed. This tool aims to simplify the exploration and usage of Juniper streaming telemetry solutions on our routing products. Before introducing the tool, we need to first answer a question. Why should I move to telemetry solutions? If we compare streaming telemetry with legacy solutions, such as SNMP, we can highlight the following advantages. We can benefit from a push model approach. gRPC telemetry supports a stream or on-chain modes, when SNMP only provides a pull mode for collecting state data. Moreover, a streaming approach scales more, allowing you to collect data more aggressively. With streaming telemetry, you can rely on a reliable and secure transport protocol. Thanks to TCP retransmissions, no more missing data in your graph. Data will also be more accurate. The timestamp is set by the router itself during the internal data connections. And one more significant advantage we can't forget to mention. As of today, most of the new counters or state data are only available via streaming telemetry. There is no more investment in SNMP. Of course, CLI is still there for manual troubleshooting. Our routing products support a bunch of sensors, each one exposing plenty of counters. To dive into this huge amount of data, we have recently released our new online tool, the Young Data Model Explorer. This one helps to probe the state and config data models, which include OpenConfig and our native Young models. But even though you have access to those huge amounts of data, sometimes it becomes complex to find out which sensors or counters I have to collect for my specific use case. This is where the tool I'm going to present you enters into the game. Well, the code name of this tool is OpenJTS. JTS stands for Juniper Telemetry Stack. Currently, OpenJTS supports routing products from the PTX 10K Evo family, SX 7K Evo to the entire MX family, including MX 10K and MX 304. The first supported software release is Genos or Evo 20.1. If I have to give you a short introduction to OpenJTS, I would say the main goal of this tool is to make the life of our customer and user easier when they wish to start playing with gRPC streaming telemetry. In a few clicks, users could enable the collection and visualization of the most common data provided by Juniper's telemetry solutions. The tool offers a complete telemetry chain, including data collections, enrichments, aggregation, storage, and finally, visualization via pre-included dashboard. In short, OpenJTS provides a set of profiles, each designed to meet a specific use case. Let's have a look at some pre-included dashboards. First, we could try the router health profile. Let's scroll down a bit to see the history of the CPU and memory of both Aries and all FPCs. You see also the per-process CPU consumption, the per-core CPU, and the per-process memory consumption graph. If we scroll down at the end of this dashboard, you will have access to some fabric states, such as the fabric drop in PPS and the input and output fabric throughput in PPS as well. We can try a second dashboard, for example, the optical profile. Let me select the specific node. And so here we talk about layer 1 and layer 2 states. You have access, thanks again to the Telegraph Alarming plugin, to all the links that have right now some framing errors. The two next tables give you some nice overall view of optic state. The first one provides for each port and lane the RX and TX current levels. The second table shows you all the current optic alarms. Finally, if we scroll down, for each optic, you will find out several different layer 1 and layer 2 KPIs. Okay, it's time to play with OpenJTS. Let's start the stack. First, we need to clone the OpenJTS repository.